What is going on, guys? My name is Cosmix, and in the background here I've got some Black Ops 2 gameplay. It's a game of Hardpoint on the map Encore. I am using the FAL with Select Fire, Red Dot and Stock. I do fairly well. I go 54 to 16, but I am going to be cutting the gameplay a bit short considering I don't think I'll be able to talk for 10 minutes straight about what I am going to talk about. So anyway, back on track, I am going to be talking about what is next for Call of Duty in terms of whether it will bring much more to the table than the previous games have done. As in all honesty, the past few Call of Duty games have just been repaints, and you guys probably know that, everyone does, but it's still the biggest selling franchise going. It outsells movies and all sorts, and we all buy it. You know, I still love it, and I'm not hating on it at all, but you know, it's just been the same game essentially, just with new maps, slightly better graphics, new kill streaks, new guns, just a few little tweaks here and there, but apart from that, it hasn't really changed. But as for Call of Duty Ghosts, I do think that will bring a lot more to the franchise this year. One of the main reasons for this is the fact that, from like rumors and all things like that, it's most likely going to be next generation consoles, and I really do hope it is, because the amount of things they could bring to the table with that, it's just going to be great. Such as, apparently they'll be bringing new movement features in, because Ali A done a video covering that, and it was stuff like being able to slide on your knees and roll while I'm prone. And if them little features get incorporated into the game, it would change it up completely. It would change the way you play. It would just change so much just from a minor little thing like that. As well as, the connection would most likely be a lot better, because I've noticed lately, especially playing Black Ops 2, I've been lagging loads and getting booted out of games and stuff like that. So the connection will most likely be better. It will run better because it's going to obviously have better hardware. You know, I'm not a big geek, so I don't know. Well, no one knows what's going into the next Xbox yet. But as well as that, it will have really good graphics from, like, well, obviously because it's going to be a next-gen console and it's just going to have such great graphics on it, so the game will run better and look better, like I've just said. But yet, there's not much more I can really add to that, apart from the fact that I do generally think it is going to be a better all-round experience when it comes to Call of Duty. Because since, I'd probably say, the favourite Call of Duty for me was Modern Warfare 2, and the only reason for that was because I was still in high school at that time, so you could basically come home and just play that game all night without worrying about anything really, until like the last 2 years maybe, when you actually start thinking, shit, I've got to get some qualifications to get to actually live. But yeah, I remember back in the Modern Warfare 2 days being able to come home, just sit for hours on end with friends, just playing on like great maps like High Rise and Terminal. Oh, they were the days for me, Modern Warfare 2. But I actually didn't really get into Call of Duty 4 till at the end of its like lifespan, because I didn't get Xbox Live until, well, I can't even remember when I got that, but I got it late to everyone else. So when I joined, Call of Duty 4 was kind of running out, and yeah, that's why Modern Warfare 2 was the biggest one for me. And since then, I don't, in my opinion, none has really beat it. But Black Ops 2 is a close second, because I think that is better than Modern Warfare 3 and Black Ops 1, hands down. But yeah, like I said, Modern Warfare 2 all the way for me. Yeah, so anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Please leave a like, comment, and maybe subscribe if you want to. I have been Cosmix, and I shall see you all later.